No, no more swear words.
That's fine.
Show planned for you tonight. I'm your host, Clarissa Bustamante.
And I'm Alexander Franks.
And I'm Lauren Dedman.
And I'm Daniel Truitt.
All right, so we have a lot of great things planned for tonight, starting with all of our summer blockbusters. Our first summer blockbuster is Suicide Squad, which has been making a lot of waves. A lot of people have a lot of different feelings about this. I know I loved it. How did you feel about it?
I was not a fan. I was on the bandwagon with everybody else. I know you were obsessed with it. I tried to take your opinion before I watched it. I only watched it because of you. And I just thought it was a really great story that was not well executed.
Yeah. I completely disagree. I think it was an amazing movie, not only because of the storyline, which I know differs a little bit from the original, but I think the characters or the actors took a lot of time to build their characters, to study them, and they really went all out, especially except for Cara Delevingne, who was horrible.
Always.
But I think Margot Robbie and Jared Leto as the Joker was really, really good. Lauren, you guys over there, what do you guys think about it?
I was really hyped. Well, I wasn't hyped about it at first. I was just kind of hesitant about it because I knew they were going like a weird direction. But then everyone else started kind of getting me hyped about it, so I was excited. But then when the moment came, I was severely disappointed by the movie. I feel like it was a good movie in its own right, but I feel like as far as like the comic book movie, like the characters that I've already kind of been accustomed to, I didn't like this new colorful, strange take on it.
Yes, yeah. I agree. Like, I was not a fan of the movie at all. The only thing I did really like about it was that like they had some really good actors in there, Will Smith.
Yeah. Oh, Will Smith was great.
Yes.
I mean, like, some people might say Jared Leto was great, but in my opinion, I think he's probably one of the worst Jokers that we've had.
I would have to agree for that one, too.
That's a really bold statement. And I think, well, one of the things that happened is that a lot of his scenes got cut out, actually.
Oh.
They were talking about how he filmed so much more, and they cut out over half of his scenes. So do you think that if he had more of a chance to show himself as a Joker, do you think that you would maybe change your mind and think that he wasn't the worst Joker?
I just I think back to the entire movie, and the only thing I picture is just him like, and it's like in that laugh of his, like, I'm just like, I don't know, like, it made me uncomfortable more than anything.
I think that was the point, right? To make you uncomfortable. He's the Joker.
Yeah.
He's evil.
Yeah,
I really think the whole movie sort of made me uncomfortable. Like, it was a little.
I mean, I agree to disagree.
Yes.
Okay.
Let's talk about Finding Dory.
Yes, that was on my list.
Finding Dory?
Yes. As soon as I saw the trailer, I just knew like that.
You
was
knew
for sure I was going to go see that movie.
Did you guys like Finding Nemo as kids?
I love Finding Nemo. That was the first movie I ever saw in theaters, was Finding Nemo. It was like my 9th birthday. I was so pumped.
It's a classic. And I think definitely people want to watch Finding Dory because they watch Finding Nemo.
Oh, yeah.
And I know I cried. I wanted to watch it with my parents because it was so sweet. I think it was an emotional movie, and it was really good for the whole family.
Yeah.
I really like it as well.
All my friends said not to go see it. And so I just was like, really? Yeah, I'm with y'all. I agree that I watched Finding Nemo as a kid. I honestly hated Finding Nemo as a kid. I don't know why. Maybe I just wanted to be different. I don't remember. But I was in love with Finding Dory. It got 94% on Rotten Tomatoes. I love Rotten Tomatoes.
You liked Finding Dory, but you didn't like Finding Nemo?
Like, looking back now, if I watch it, I love Finding Nemo.
Okay.
I see the innocence.
Okay.
As a child, I was like, why are they trying to make me act like a little kid?
Well, when I was watching Finding Nemo, I feel like my favorite character was Dory. So it's like...
Yes.
So there you go. They made a whole movie about your favorite
Dory,
character.
So I was like, of course, I have to go see it.
I mean, I like Bubbles, but, you know, it's just me.
Exactly. Okay, and then we have Ghostbusters, which I know that caused a lot of controversy. I know Leslie Jones was one of the main characters, and she got a lot of negative feedback for her role in the movie. Do you think that was warranted, or?
You know, I don't really have an opinion on this one very much. I am not like a big mystery fan, so mm-hmm. I thought she did a great job. I don't really like Kristen Wiig. I didn't really like this cast overall. So I guess I can kind of agree with that she maybe didn't do the best job because it wasn't my favorite cast.
I know the idea behind the movie. They want to kind of say like, oh, women in Hollywood, you know, try to like put all woman casts, but it's just like, I feel like that is a good sentiment, but the way they went about it was just all wrong. Like, I feel like the movie was terrible. It didn't push that message. It's just like the whole movie, it just felt like the humor behind it it seemed a little more immature. Like, it didn't feel like the Ghostbusters. Yeah.
Yes.
And the idea, like, it's not saying like women are strong, they could do it too. They're all stereotypical characters. And then every guy in the movie is just portrayed as like this stupid person. I don't know. I completely agree.
I think they definitely went about it in the wrong way, but I think casting wise, I think they did a fantastic job. That might be because I love Saturday Night Live and these three women, Kristen Wiig, Leslie Jones, and
Melissa
McCarthy, and Kate McKinnon. Yeah. They've all been featured on SNL, and I think they're fantastic actresses.
But do you think these movies were good summer blockbusters, though?
Not a summer blockbuster, maybe just like a good movie.
Just good little movies in their own right.
But for me, for the Ghostbusters, if I had to choose between the old one and a new one, most definitely the old Ghostbusters. Mm-hmm. That's a classic, you know?
And I think that if the new one was a success, I think people might still prefer the old one because it's a classic. Mm-hmm.
I do appreciate their attempt at female power, though. I think that was, like Star Wars, a very good try.
And maybe this is just a start, you know? Maybe the next one will be even better.
You never know.
And then we have Sausage Party, which was directed by Seth Rogen, and he also voiced one of the characters. Very interesting film. What do you guys think about it?
Sausage Party, like, when I first saw it, I was immediately put off by it because, like, just the way everything looked, the style, like, the way, like, the humor, it seemed like it was going to be, like, a very immature, and it's, like, Seth Rogen, he's, like, hit or miss. Like, he's either really good or he's just kind of, like, really crude humor.
He has a really, really strange sense of humor.
But everyone's saying the movie's, like, really good. Everyone's, like, saying they love it. So, like, I'm going to have to definitely give it a chance now.
Me, personally, I did. Like, when I first saw the trailer, I saw it on Facebook, and I was like, okay, this might be a kid's movie. But then, like, you hear the characters talk, and it's like, oh, no, this is not. So, I was like, nobody's ever done this before. So, I feel like he succeeded in that.
I think that this film has a very targeted audience. I don't think that this is for everyone. I don't think it's a family movie. You know, I don't think it's for kids. I think it's just for people who happen to share the same sense of humor as Seth Rogen.
Some very dirty words dropped.
Very dirty. And then we have The Secret Life of Pets, which on the opposite end, I think is a very family-friendly movie.
It's awesome. I think it's one of the greatest movies of the year. Looking back on some statistics, people were most likely to enjoy, over the past 10 years, movies with animals or movies with superheroes in them.
Okay.
So this was, or with talking animals, actually. Yeah. So I loved it.
Honestly,
I've wondered what my pet does at home for my entire life. So I love to see that brought to life.
Do you think this was an accurate description of what your pet does at home?
I think so. I think my pet's like the snooty poodle, you know.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna cut to commercial. When we come back, we're gonna talk about some of the new movies that recently came to Netflix and some of the ones that went away.
People always take me for granted. They told me I didn't have a lot to offer. But they were wrong. I dream of making a difference. I want to start over and try again. Have you ever wanted a second chance?
Thank you. I get here?
One pill is enough. Don't sell your prescription.
Here in Northwest Arkansas, we have so many people who are in such dire need for food. Why are we throwing this away?
Razorback Food Recovery was started by a group of students as a registered student organization. We were then adopted by the Volunteer Action Center, and they took over the program and made it one of their signature programs. We give food to about four or five organizations.
Welcome back to Razorback Reels. Now we're going to be talking about some of the movies that are coming to Netflix and some of the movies that we're missing. We're going to start off with Narcos Season 2, which I don't like Narcos.
I love Narcos.
Narcos is so good.
I love it, yes.
Like, the thing about, like Narcos, like, I just recently started watching Season 1, and I burned through it, like, so fast. And, like, I just loved how, like, it starts, it feels like a documentary, but it's, like, drama at the same time. And then Season 2 dropped, like, on my birthday. And it was, like, Netflix's little birthday to me.
Wow.
But, not to look a gift horse in the mouth, it wasn't as good as Season 1, in my opinion.
I agree. Absolutely.
Like, it's just, like, as far as it became like, a documentary. It just felt more like a drama. It felt like a soap opera. It felt like it was a lot of, like, pointless, like, little storylines, little things, episodes that don't matter towards anything. I don't know. Overall, it was great, but, you know.
Right. So next we have the Jaws series, which is coming back to Netflix on September 1st, which I don't really care about that either. I mean, I think it's great, but
I'm not a fan of Jaws. Never have been.
I think it's great that Jaws 1 is on there. All the other ones, I don't think they should have bothered putting them on Netflix.
Well, you know what? Maybe now this gives us a chance to rewatch them and, you know, give them another chance. Maybe we'll like them now.
They terrified me for my entire life.
Oh, but you know what? Now you're older and maybe you're not afraid anymore.
Maybe I'll realize it's
something
fake.
Like that.
Yeah.
And then we have Amityville Horror, which might be okay, but
I'm not the scary movie series type of person. Like, that will give me nightmares. Like, even like just one episode, I'm just like, I cannot sleep at night. So maybe not for you.
That's
a thumbs down for me.
I'm with you on that one.
All right, and so all those are coming, which is great, but unfortunately that means that some shows are leaving us, including Zoolander, which is one of my favorite movies of all time. I don't think they should take it off, but
it's gone but not forgotten.
It's one of them.
Gone but not forgotten.
One of people's favorite movie of all time.
Yeah, it's
classic. It's Ben Stiller.
Yeah, that's one of those movies that, like, it's the quotes from that movie make its way into, like, my vocabulary, like, on a daily basis pretty much.
Did you guys like Zoolander too?
No.
Okay.
I feel like so whenever classic. They make a remake, a 2, a 3, it's never as good enough as a.
Yeah. It's like, I think it's like Anchorman all over again. The first one was great, super quotable, and the second one they just try to live up to it, and they try to.
Never can.
But they're trying to make this movie that's quotable, and it just falls flat.
Just like Narcos.
Just like Narcos.
Just like Narcos.
All right, and one thing I'm definitely gonna miss is A Walk to Remember.
Oh,
classic
gosh,
Nicholas
yes.
Sparks. Super sappy, hits me in the heart.
Classic Mandy Moore.
I mean, yes, who doesn't love Mandy? I mean, like, love her in that movie.
Doesn't matter
so
how many
much
times.
From beginning to end.
It's so heartfelt.
It is.
That was before Nicholas Sparks got too cheesy, too.
So why are you gonna miss it exactly? I mean, obviously you're really upset that it's leaving, but, you know, why is...
I guess that was my first taste of young love, and it kind of like brings to light that love can be really, really life-altering, but also not last. So,
so it's teaching you about life and
it
love.
It taught me about life, and it really was a walk that I've always remembered. So,
so this is really going to be hard for you to watch it go.
Rough. I'm going to have to buy it on Amazon Video for $3.
I mean, no, I'm my heart's aching for you guys, but I'm more upset about the Disney movies that are leaving. Like, Emperor's New Groove, Lilo and Stitch. Like
Emperor's New Groove.
I'm not even going to lie. I watched those on Netflix like 2 months ago. Like, I was happy they were there, and now they're gone. They took it from me.
I'm just hoping they add more Disney movies now.
Absolutely. Yes. I think every once in a while, everyone just be like, hey, let's watch Netflix and let's just watch a good Disney movie. Those are just classics, and everybody can agree on them because everybody grew up with them for the most part. Yeah. Especially Emperor's New Groove. I think my favorite character was Krunk. I think he was hilarious. Do you guys have a favorite character on that show?
I like the Emperor.
I like the squirrel. Sure. The squirrel dancing. Definitely is up there.
Oh, Squeaky squirrel.
Squeakerton, yeah.
Squeaker.
Squeaker, they call him.
That's fantastic.
Classic.
Do you wish that you had a little squeaky Squeakerton
as well? I think we all wish that.
What would you guys do if you turned into a llama?
Right? I think he handled it pretty well.
I thought he did.
I don't know. How would you handle it?
I haven't considered the situation.
Yes, I've never considered that, really.
I wouldn't wear clothes anymore. I'd just walk around in my fur.
I completely agree. I think that's a great idea.
I hadn't thought about it, but I guess there is an appeal to being a llama.
Live my dream and eat all I can.
And with that, we're going to take it to commercial, but when we come back, we'll talk about our Emmy nominations.
Take me for granted. They told me I didn't have a lot to offer. But they were wrong. I dream of making a difference. I want to start over and try again. Have you ever wanted a second chance?
How did I get here?
Welcome back to Razorback Reels, and now we're going to be talking about our Emmy predictions for the Emmy Awards coming up. So for the very first topic, we have Outstanding Drama Series, and this includes Game of Thrones, Better Call Saul, Mr. Robot, House of Cards, Homeland, The Americans, and Downton Abbey. Now, I know my pick is Better Call Saul. I think that they did a fantastic job with that. I know Lauren agrees with me, right?
Yes, of course. When I first saw that, I was like, didn't know what to think about it, and I just had to like keep it on my TV, and then it's like one of those series that you just have to keep watching, and then you love it. So
I completely agree.
My pick.
And this is for Outstanding Drama Series.
Yeah. Okay. I would like something like, okay, there's a lot of the shows that are in this category, like The American, Mr. Robot, House of Cards. They all seem like they're very like political or like drama, things like that. Mm-hmm. But, like, I recently started watching House of Cards, and I was hooked immediately. Like, it just feels like so different. Like, some of the things are less mundane than some of the other like TV shows like that, but it just seems so intense. And then like the main character, like the anti-hero, like he's just like a sociopath, and you just like find yourself rooting for him. And like, I don't know, like I've been hooked immediately. I'm already like, I've watched like 2 seasons in like a week.
Well, you better slow down. I don't know how much is left for you to watch. Yes.
All right, my pick was Game of Thrones. I'm very surprised that nobody has said that yet. I did not want to like the series because everyone told me to like the series, and I guess I'm a little bit stubborn, but I finally had a week off during the summer, so I watched all 6 seasons that are available on Netflix.
That's crazy how easily we can all binge watch TV.
Yes, it's so like sickly interesting to
me. How do you deal with all your favorite characters dying all the time? That must be really hard for you.
Because someone told me beforehand to not get too attached, there was only one time when Ygritte died. And my heart just broke and I wept.
Spoiler alert.
Sorry. I'm so sorry. To help all of you weepers out there.
I don't know that you're really sorry about that.
My issue with the show, though, is just that, like, I think a lot of the other seasons are really good, but this season, this was, like, my least favorite season. Like, there was, like, a better storyline, but as far as, like, best drama, like, I didn't have any like emotional reaction to this series. Like, this is the one series that, like, I didn't fear for the main characters. It didn't resonate with me as well. So it's like, I just don't think that this is the year for it to receive best drama.
I agree. I don't know about that. But for outstanding comedy, we have Transparent, Silicon Valley, Veep, Modern Family, Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt, Blackish, and Master of None. Okay, I mean, I'm just going to go ahead and say I think Modern Family is way ahead of everybody else. They have a star-studded cast. It's been great since season one, since the pilot. They have just consistently been putting out more creative content. Their characters are fantastic. You know, who plays Gloria? What's her name?
Sophia
Vergara. I mean, since she started on that show, she's done so many things with CoverGirl and different beauty lines and things like that, and I think that show is just fantastic, and everybody else is fantastic.
It really is. I love it so much, and I mean, like, I think I've been watching this for years. It started off with me and my mom, and now it's just like I do it on my own, and I'm like, I love Modern Family. It's so funny, and it has just like its quirks to it that it just makes you love the family like it's yours.
Yeah, and it's very relevant too. Yes. I mean, like the title suggests, it really does depict a modern family. And I think that's awesome in television, the way that it can influence viewers and stuff like that. So the fact that everybody loves everyone on that show, everybody should love everybody in America.
Because, and now since I'm thinking about it, it does have like a variety of families because, you know, Gloria's with the older man. Uh-huh. And then, you know, it's the same-sex marriage with a child as well.
It's really fun to see.
Yeah, with an adopted child from China.
It really does.
And like the other comedies on the list too, I think they're really good all in their own right, but I feel like Modern Family, it's already won it like 5 years in a row. I don't think anything's going to stop this train right now. I think it's going to win another one.
And they don't stick too much to one storyline to where they can wave any direction and people are entertained.
Yeah.
I think something that definitely deserves an honorable mention though is Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt. I think that is a fantastic show. I think it's hilarious. Tina Fey wrote it, which is again me just really sticking to my SNL characters.
Oh yeah.
But I think it's hilarious. Do you guys think that it's anywhere near Modern Family?
No. I think
it's more colorful, it's lively, it's fun to watch, but I don't think it has like as creative of a thing. It's more ridiculous, and I can appreciate it for that, but it's like, I don't know, it's just...
And she's such a doll face. I mean, she's so cute. Mm-hmm.
Little Kimmy. And I think Titus is a fantastic character. Yeah. He's so funny, but I agree with you guys in that it doesn't really go anywhere near Modern Family.
No.
Modern Family's going to win it again.
For sure.
And you know what? And you know what? Blackish also, I think, deserves a little bit of credit. Do you guys think so?
Yeah, I do.
I've only watched a couple episodes of it, and I mean, it is entertaining, but nothing makes me want to watch it more. So that's my problem with that.
If it's on, you'll sit down with your friends.
Yes, but if it was my choice,
no extra thumb muscles being used.
I guess I can see that. I know, like, my dad, he loves it. Anytime he comes, he's like, Clarissa, Blackish is on. You need to watch it. You guys need to watch it. And I don't know why. I don't know what his draw to it is, but I guess that he probably isn't the only one that feels that way, considering that it's on this list.
Very true.
And it is sort of like raw comedy because, you know, they make fun of issues that are apparent in the world, but they make it, you know, funny. So it's I can see why it is listed.
Do you think maybe it winning would help with the diversity inside the Emmy Awards, or do you think that it's just another show that may or may not win?
It's just another show that's not going to win.
Yeah, I don't think
Modern Family. Modern Family's there's no like.
I mean, for sure think that Modern Family is taking it home for sure.
And I think Modern Family would help with the diversity. So.
Yes, I mean, yeah,
I agree. All right, so next we have Outstanding Lead Actor in a Drama Series. I love all of these characters, or all these actors. What do you guys think?
I can't really pick. Kyle Chandler from Bloodline, who's also from Friday Night Lights.
Okay.
And every girl I know thinks that he is some kind of handsome-looking man.
I mean, I guess.
But he also is just very serious, like, to the point, stays in his character. If I saw him on the street, I would think that he was the character that he's playing in Bloodline.
Okay. So do you like him because he's so attractive?
I think that definitely plays into it. He probably gets 2 points for attractive and 8 points for acting. Because he's a father in that, he's a detective, he's a brother, he's a family member.
So he's a man of many talents.
He's a man of so many talents, okay. And he leads the entire show. Without him, without John, there would be no Bloodline.
Okay.
He's the leader of the Bloodline. Yes.
All right, so I guess we know what she thinks.
Yes.
Who's going to win. So, Lauren, what are you thinking?
I'm going to have to agree, but mine is strictly because of his look. Sorry. Like, how can you not just want to look at that? But, I mean, he is a really good actor. So, yeah, I mean, I enjoy it. So, I enjoy looking at him. So, I'm sold.
Daniel, do you also think that he should win because he's so attractive?
No. Like, attractiveness aside, I was talking about acting chops. Like, Kevin Spacey in House of Cards. Like I said, I loved House of Cards. I thought it was a great show. But the thing that hooked me into it was like Kevin Spacey, like his acting. Like, it's like he's calm, he's confident, but he's like he's a sociopath. But it's like it's just like his calm, his delivery. Like, he's just like a really engaging like actor. Like, it's like I believe everything that's going on. You know, while I'm watching it, I'm not thinking, oh, this is Kevin Spacey. I'm like, this is Frank Underwood. This is his character. Yeah. And, like, I don't know. He just really drew me into the show.
He is. Robin Wright is also nominated.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I thought she was really good, too. But I think she's a really good actress. But I feel like she didn't really take the show. I think she's really good in the show itself, but I think she's just too far outshined by Kevin Spacey's performance in the show.
Well, so she's in her own category, mm-hmm. you know, as a lead actress. So do you think that, you know, without competing with Kevin Spacey, do you think that she's going to win?
I think it's possible. I think she did really good, but I think it's just his performance is just going to kind of drown her out. I don't think they're going to take, you know, like they're both really good actresses, but I don't feel as though they're... The two of them together are each gonna win, like in a little category. It's just, I'm so conflicted. I really did like her character, but I think she's just too far outshined to get noticed, even for her own category.
I guess I understand that. So if she's too far outshined, who do you, Alexandra? I think in your opinion, what do you think? Who do you think is gonna win this?
For the lead
for
actor?
For actress, yes.
Or actress?
Lead actress in a drama series.
Oh, Taraja P. Henson from Empire. I think she's a doll face. I think she's so intense when she needs to be intense, and she laughs when she needs to laugh, and she knows how to connect with her audience on a personal level.
I mean, those are really good qualities. In an actress, I think that's an Emmy Award-winning intro for her. Lauren, quickly, what do you think?
I agree. Taraji P. Henson, she's always been my girl since Sister, so that's when she was really young. So, yeah. So, I enjoy watching her on Empire. She is the go-to girl.
I forgot she was on Sister.
Yes.
Yeah, actually, I didn't know that either.
Yeah, she's been around for a long time.
Was that her first show with Sister?
I'm not for sure, so I don't want to say. But, I mean, she was really young.
She was on Boys in the Hood.
Yes.
And she sings in that soundtrack, and it's awesome.
All right, well, that's all the time we have for tonight. So this is Razorback Reels. Follow us on Twitter @Razorback Reels. Have a great night, guys.